Basically, I wanted to tell you what are the mistakes I have done, because of which maybe, I mean, those mistakes you can avoid. Being a student and you have a long career ahead, you can avoid. And I think most of it, Narayana, Ananya, Aditi and others have kind of summarized it. But one thing I would want to say is, when you are selecting your area of interest, the kind of field that you want to be, trust me, go by your heart. Don't go because your friend is saying so, your parents are saying so, or somebody else is saying so. You are the one who is going to do that work for the next minimum 20 years, maximum 35 to 40 years. Can you do it? Question yourself. You want to become a doctor, you have passion for that, go for it. But if you want to become an engineer and somebody else is pushing you for a doctor, no. It's a big no-no because you just can't survive. All of you agree that Sachin Tendulkar is the god of cricket? No, okay, I heard for Virat Kohli also a big no-no. But anyways, I consider him as a god of cricket even now. So, how many of you agree that he was successful as a captain? No, he was not, right? He was god of cricket, but then as a captain, he didn't really do well. Why? Because we all have our areas of expertise. And we need to focus on that particular area and not get deviated because somebody else is saying something. You know, I just remembered a joke. So there was this man, he had a lot of hens, chicken. So he tells, he has a farm of chicken. So he tells every chicken, every day you have to lay an egg. 7 days, every day you have to lay an egg. On the seventh day, if all of you have not laid 7 eggs each every day, then I'm going to kill you. So then, on the seventh day, he calls everyone and he says everybody has laid 7 eggs except for one. One damn fellow has not laid 7 eggs. He's only laid like 3 eggs. Then this fellow will call him and say, oh, you're so daring. You're ready to die, is it? You don't give a damn for death, is it? You know what that chicken says? Guru, I'm so sorry. I tried my level best to lay 7 eggs, but I'm a rooster. I'm a hoonja. How will I lay eggs? In spite of that, I tried and laid 3 eggs. So don't become that hoonja, don't become that rooster trying to do something that you can't but forcefully doing it. You will not enjoy it. So select the profession, select the area, select the job you would love to do for the next 30 years, next 35 years. Don't give up on that. One other thing, I was very impressed by what Narayan said. Don't read for the heck of it. Understand and read. He also mentioned about NCERT, by the way. How many of you want to do civil services? I can't see the hands because it's too dark for me, but I'm assuming there are people who want to do civil services. Trust me, it's a very good field. If you want to do civil services, right from now, start concentrating on the NCERTs. Most of your prelims, most of your mains questions come from the NCERTs, believe it or not. People say it is a very difficult exam to crack. If with 70-80% marks, I could crack AAS, I'm sure all of you can easily crack IAS. So, NCERT is a place. So, like he rightly said, don't read for the heck of it. I did that mistake. I did my BSc in computer science because everybody was going there and I had to mug up programs. Imagine I had to mug up programs, literally mug up programs. So don't do it. How many of you know swimming here? What about cycling? Okay, quite a few hands. Okay, I'll do one thing. For the next 10 years, I'm going to take off your bicycles and I'm not going to allow you to touch the pool. After 10 years, if I give you a cycle and if I put you in the pool, will you be able to swim? Will you be able to cycle? Perfect. That is because you love to do it. You are learning it and not reading it or you're not doing it for others. That is what you have to do, guys. Anything that you read, anything that you do, understand it. Civil service is all about understanding. It is raining, the weather turns warm. Why does it turn? That is what you need to understand. Cyclones are formed in Bay of Bengal more. Very less in Arabian Sea. Why is it formed less in Arabian Sea? That is what you have to understand. Where you will get it? You will get it in the NCERTs. So that is where you have to go back. By the way, when you don't understand a concept from your lecturer, go back to him and ask. I'm not understanding. All of you know APJ Abdul Kalam? I'm a diehard fan of APJ Abdul Kalam. You know, when he was 10 years old in Rameshwaram, his teacher was teaching him how to fly. And all of them, teacher taught him about flying and all that. Then teacher asked him, so all of you understood about flying? The entire class said, yeah, yeah, we understood. APJ said, no, I didn't understand. What are you talking? I didn't understand. Then teacher was like, okay, must be something more you want to know. So he took him to the beach and then he tried explaining how the body weight is reduced, how they fly with the flapping their wings and all that. So that time he decided, I want to fly fighter jets. He flew rockets. So that is the kind of focus, that's the kind of understanding you need to develop now. And one other thing is, better late than never. There is never a late scenario, trust me. If, like me, you have got into science, arts, commerce because somebody else wanted you to, you still have a long life to change it and go to the area you want. You know, when sir was reading about the annual report, sir mentioned about Kavya, who has gone to Hungary, right, for a medical seat. So when he said Hungary, I was reminded of a real story of a shooter from Hungary. How many of you have heard about Carolyn Tuckers? Okay, I see some hands. So he was, in the 1930s, he was a well-known shooter in Hungary. And his focus was to win 1940 Olympics. So he's practicing, entire Hungary knew that he's going to bag the Olympics gold medal for us. He was very sure about that. But 1938, during a war, by mistake, a bomb explodes in his hand and he loses his right hand. So 1938, he lost his right hand. Shooter losing his right hand. What will happen? If I was one, I would have crashed. Maybe I would have gone underground, cried whole of my life, done something like that. He cried, but then he realized, what is he achieving by crying? Nothing. He saw his left hand and he thought, oh, I have another hand. Why not train this? He started practicing in 1938 with his left hand. He tried, and then his focus was 1940 Olympics. What happens? World War, Second World War. There's no Olympics. So he focuses on 1944. Again, Olympics gets cancelled. World War. Did he lose hopes? No. He focused on 1948. Imagine he was 28 in 1938. He becomes 38 in 1948. With age, obviously you have younger participants, younger energy, so anybody would get demotivated. He didn't. In left hand, he won gold medal in 1948. And then, did he stop? No, he didn't stop. He went for 1944, 1952. 1952, he again bags the gold medal. So that is the kind of focus. It is never late, never ever late. Trust me, with my own example, I started off with science. BSc, I realized, oh my God, science is not my cup of tea. I'm just mugging up. I don't know where I'm going to land. I like talking. I love interacting with people. Somebody said, do MBA. HR is like amazing. So I did MBA. I like the subjects. I did top my class. I got a placement. I enjoyed my tenure with Infosys for the first 2 years. There was a lot of learning, a lot of things. My career was going good. I was getting amazing ratings. And overall, my salary package was good. I got to travel on site. So overall, everything was hunky-dory. My peers were good. My manager was amazing. But still, every day when I go back home, I used to feel like, what am I doing with my life? This is what I want. Where am I ending up? Can I do this for the next 30 years? Can I? And then that thought started killing me. That's when I thought, forget it. I am going to pursue my civil service dreams, which I thought way back in childhood. I could have thought that I'm late, I have a career and I could have stopped. But I didn't because it was killing me inside and I don't like something nagging my head. That's when I gave an attempt. I flunked in UPSC. I went till after mains. I couldn't clear mains. So I flunked. Then there were a lot of people discouraging, like how these guys are toppers with 100% told. A lot of them discouraging, saying, no, you can't. It's too late for you. Leave it and all. But it's my family, my husband, my cousins, my uncle, my known ones, even my lecturers here. Everybody said, do it. Do it, you can. And finally, I did KAS at least, so I'm happy with that. So never think you are late for something. You can always catch up with time if you have that persistence, if you have that right effort. One other thing, one last thing I want to say, dream big. Don't stop at small. Dream big. World is big, so you can dream big. You know, there's this famous saying of APJ Abdul Kalam about dreams. Dream is not something that comes in your dream when you're sleeping. Dream is something that doesn't let you sleep. So dream like that.